Okay, in this nice opportunity, I would like to present one of randomized control trial. It is very good issue, I think. It is comparing intervention of the coronary artery using drug-coated balloon compared with using stent, including bare metal stent, and also drug-eluting stent. It is known as the PEP-CAP and STEMI trial. But before we continue to present this randomized control trial, I would like to show you one video about using drug-coated balloon in the coronary intervention. Okay, here it is the video. Okay, then let us continue to present this presentation about the clinical trial comparing between coronary intervention using drug-coated balloon and also using stent, including bare metal stent and also drug-eluting stent. As you know that the drug-coated balloon may avoid stent-associated long-term complication, this trial actually just to compare the clinical outcome of patient with non-ST elevation myocardial infarction treated with either using drug-coated balloon or using stent, including BMS and also DES. Okay, then here it is the method. The objective of this clinical trial is to investigate the clinical outcome of patient with non-ST elevation myocardial infarction non-ST elevation myocardial infarction treated with the drug-coated balloon, then compare to using stent, in this case including bare metal stent and also drug-eluting stent. And this study actually a kind of multicenter randomized trial with the population patient with non-ST elevation myocardial infarction. And the endpoint of this clinical trial is the target lesion failure as combined death, reinfarction, and target lesion revascularization within 9 months. And the result is, you can see from this diagram, there are patients, 210 patients suffering from non-ST elevation myocardial infarction divided into two groups. The first one receiving drug-coated balloon during the coronary intervention and 106 receiving implantation of stent including bare metal stent and also drug-eluting stent. And after 9 months evaluation, it is the result, the evaluation of the target lesion failure at 9 months, you can see the target lesion failure, it is what we call identifiable as a culprit lesion without angiographic evidence of large thrombus. And the primary endpoint was target lesion failure, a combined clinical endpoint consisting of cardiac or unknown death, reinfarction, and target lesion revascularization within 9 months. And also secondary endpoint included total major adverse cardiovascular event miss and individual clinical endpoint. And from this diagram, you can see that the target lesion failure at 9 months between both of that group, from the drug-coated balloon group, the target lesion failure only 3.8%, while in the stent group, the target lesion failure is 6.6%. It means that you can see that the target lesion failure, it is little bit lower in the drug-coated balloon group. So the conclusion of this clinical control trial is, in the patient with non-ST elevation myocardial infarction, treatment of coronary de novo lesion with the drug-coated balloon was non-inferior to compare with the implantation of stent, in this case including bare metal stent and also drug-eluting stent. I think that it is a very good issue or such kind of thing that maybe need further more investigation at the near future. Okay, thank you very much.